So PRP, or platelet-rich plasma, is a therapy that has been getting a lot of buzz lately as a possible treatment for knee osteoarthritis. But the biggest question is that, what is PRP and does it really work? So in this video, we're going to look at the science behind PRP and we're going to find out if the PRP is going to be a game changer for knee osteoarthritis treatment or not. Again, this is an evolving topic and a subjective change every year. Now let us first talk about what PRP is. So basically the PRP stands for platelet-rich plasma. So basically they draw your own blood and your blood has a lot of components including red blood cells, white blood cells and platelets. Basically the blood is centrifuged, so basically it's spun around to get a concentrated platelet plasma. So instead of describing how PRP works, let us just discuss how we expect the PRP to work. So the platelet-rich plasma has a lot of growth factors, making it ideal for growing back your cartilage. Additionally, growth factors create signals to decrease inflammation. Consequently, in theory, this treatment has the potential to improve your knee arthritis by replenishing worn out cartilage and decreasing inflammation. Sounds amazing, right? I want the PRP to work in the same manner that we expect it to. But what does the evidence show? So I'm not here to say that one of my friends got PRP and he got an amazing relief from PRP, right? That's not evidence, right? That could have been just an expensive placebo effect. So what we are looking for is that does the majority of the people who get the PRP injection get benefit? That's number one. And even if they do get benefit, is that a clinically significant benefit, right? In research, sometimes we use pain scale improvement to look for clinical improvement, or we use an improvement in function to measure the clinical impact. For this purpose, I'm going to use two recent good studies. So one is a meta-analysis study, and the other is a well-controlled, blinded, randomized controlled trial. So in the meta-analysis study, they looked at the effects of PRP and they compared it to saline injection, then they compared it to steroid injections, and then they compared it to hyaluronic acid injection, which is also called as the rooster cone injections. So I don't want to get into the nitty-gritty details of this study. If I did, this video is going to be more than 10 minutes long. So basically what they found was that PRP definitely produced an improvement. However, it was not significantly different compared to the other injections in the short term around less than 3 month mark. The theme that you see is that PRP starts to do better compared to other injections around the 6 month mark, and sometimes it lasts for 12 months. There were two studies that compared three PRP injections versus a single PRP injection, and they did not show any superiority over three injections compared to two. So even though the research studies show that the PRP actually did better at the 6 month mark and 12 month mark, right? There is research significance, there is statistical significance, but does that translate to meaningful clinical improvement? And the answer is, I cannot say with confidence that it did. So there was another study done in Australia comparing PRP and saline. It was a blinded study, so the patients didn't know what they were getting. They looked at any improvement in cartilage growth, followed by any improvement in pain and function. The results did not show any improvement in any of the outcomes up to the 1 year mark. Both groups had an improvement in pain, illustrating the placebo response. So as a board certified family medicine sports medicine doctor, many of my patients ask my recommendations whether they should consider PRP injection for knee arthritis. And it's my duty to provide an honest opinion on this. Otherwise, they're vulnerable to false promises if I don't. See, pain from knee arthritis is caused by multiple factors. As I've discussed in my previous videos, your weight matters. Whether or not you're doing physical therapy matters. What you're eating matters. This is essential for managing your knee arthritis. PRP is going to be more like icing on the cake. Now the biggest question is that, should you consider PRP over other injections that are available, such as the gel injections and the steroid injections? And the good thing is that the other injections can be cheaper and some of the insurance might cover it. The PRP is not covered by insurance. So let's compare PRP and hyaluronic acid injection. So some people might argue saying that, you know, the PRP did better at the 6 month mark and 12 month mark compared to the hyaluronic acid injection. But even though the research shows a statistical significance, it's still arguable that if it did provide any meaningful clinical outcome. So what about PRP versus a cortisone injection, or also called as a steroid injection? The cortisone injection is a steroid, right? And there are side effects from steroids such as raising your blood sugar. There is a questionable concern of worsening arthritis. So I've attached a link above if you want to know more about cortisone injections for osteoarthritis. So all it boils down is this one point. Even if PRP is going to be providing just a placebo effect, Is it worth spending the money? So unfortunately, I cannot provide an answer on this, right? So because it varies from person to person. But the key question is that, let us say if you don't have enough money, right? Are you missing a magic treatment to help with your knee osteoarthritis? And the answer is no, as of the current evidence that we have, right? In addition to that, the PRP is not covered by insurance in USA, which means that you're going to spend anywhere between $300 to $2,000, and even more than that, right? The other complicating factors here is that we don't have a proper preparation, like a standardized proper consensus on the preparation for the PRP. There is leukocyte-rich PRP, there is leukocyte-poor PRP. There are studies shows that leukocyte-poor PRP is probably good for knee arthritis, but still, again, there is no consensus, and every regenerative medicine expert will have their own take on this. I hope this video was helpful. If you have any questions or comments, please post in the comment box below, and I'll see you in my next video. Until then, goodbye.